Good morning. Good morning. Grace and peace in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Welcome to everyone in sanctuary. Welcome to everyone online, whichever camera I'm looking at. Friends, if you are able, would you please join us in our call to worship? Please stand.
We'll start over again. Who can raise these bones from death?
Christ has pulled us from the grave.
Who can heal these wounds and scars?
Christ invites us back to grace.
He has risen.
He has risen indeed. Friends, we invite you to join us for our first song, which should be Jesus Paid It All.
Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Yeah, here we go. We're going to kind of swing this one.
I hear the Savior say, thy strength indeed is small, child of weakness, watch and pray. Find in me thine all in all. Jesus paid it all to him I owe. Sin had left a crimson stain, he washed it white as snow. Oh, now indeed I find thy power and thy divine can change the leper spot. Heart of stone, Jesus paid it all to him I owe. Sin had left a crimson stain, he washed it white as snow. For nothing good have I, whereby thy grace to claim. I'll wash my garments white in the blood of Calvary's Lamb. Jesus paid it all, to him I owe. Sin had left a crimson stain, he washed it white as snow. And when before the throne I stand in him complete, Jesus died my soul to my lips shall still repeat, Jesus paid it all to him I owe. Sin had left a crimson stain, he washed it white as snow.
Amen. Heavenly Father, thank you so much for the smell of new mowed grass, and for the beautiful sunshine that we're enjoying. Lord, we pray for health and for the wealth of family and friends, Lord Jesus.
Of my enemies, I raise a hallelujah louder than the unbelief. I raise a hallelujah. Our weapon is a melody. I raise a hallelujah. Heaven comes to fight for me. I'm gonna sing in the middle of the storm, louder and louder. You're gonna hear my praises roar. praise the hallelujah. With everything inside of me, I raise a hallelujah. I will watch the darkness flee. I raise a hallelujah. In the middle of the mystery, I raise a hallelujah. You lost your hold on me. I'm gonna sing in the middle of the storm, louder and louder. I'm gonna hear my praises roar. Up from the ashes, hope will arise. Death is defeated, the King is alive. Sing a little louder. Heaven comes and fights for me. Sing a little louder. I'm gonna sing in the middle of the storm. Louder and louder. You're gonna hear my praises roar. Up from the ashes, hope will arise. Death is defeated, the King is alive.
We have a New Testament reading. I'll go ahead and use my earpiece. New Testament reading, Acts 3, 12 through 19. It's actually, I believe, an Old Testament.
Acting as
a New Testament reading. When Peter saw this, he said to them, "Men of Israel, why does this surprise you? Why do you stare? Why do you stare at us as if by our own power or godliness we had made this man walk? The God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, the God of our fathers, has glorified his servant Jesus. You handed him over to be killed, and you disowned him before Pilate, though he had decided to let him go. You disowned the holy and righteous one and asked that a murderer be released to you. You killed the author of life, But God raised him. He raised him up from the dead. We are witnesses of this by faith in the name of Jesus. This man, whom you see and know, was made strong. It is Jesus' name, that the faith that comes through him, that has given this complete healing to him, as you can all see. Now, brothers, I know that you acted in ignorance, as did your leaders. But this is how God fulfilled what he had foretold through all of the prophets, saying that this is Christ who suffered. Repent then and turn to God so that your sins may be wiped out, that times of refreshing may come from the Lord. So ends the reading of the scripture. Next we have our choir. Our wonderful choir, it'll be good to hear them, good to see them. And they'll be singing Holy and Mighty. Our second reading comes from 1 John 3, 1 through 7. How great is the love the Father has vanquished on us, that he should be called children, that we should be called children of God. Back up just a smidge, because I'll miss. Thank you. And that is what we are. The reason the world does not know us is that we did not know him. Dear friends, now we are children of God, and what we will be, not yet been made known. But we know that when he appears, we shall be like him, for we shall see him as he is. Everyone who has hope in him purifies himself, just as he is pure. Everyone who sins breaks the law. In fact, sin is lawlessness. But you know that he appeared so that he might take away our sins. And in him is no sin. No one who lives in him keeps on sinning. No one who continues to sin has either seen him or known him. Dear children, do not let anyone lead you astray. He who does what is right is righteousness and is righteous. He and as he is righteous. And I'd like to invite anybody that would like to come up and read any Sunday morning the scriptures. You are more than welcome to get a hold of one of us or call the office. We would really love for you to stand up here and share in reading.
The Word of God for the people of God. Mm-hmm. Thanks be to God. We have another song, don't we?
Mm-hmm.
Friends, we invite you to stand as you are able and join us in our next song, In Christ Alone.
In Christ alone, my hope is found. He is my light, my strength, my song. His cornerstone, his solid ground, firm through the fiercest drought and storm. What heights of love, what depths of peace, when fears are still with striving cease. My comforter, my all in all, here in the love of Christ I stand. In Christ alone he took on flesh, fullness of God, my helpless babe. This gift of love and righteousness, scorned by the ones he came to save. Till on that cross, as Jesus died, the wrath of God was satisfied. For every sin on him was laid. Here in the death of Christ I live. There in the ground his body lay, light of the world by darkness slain. Then bursting forth in glorious day, up from the grave he rose again. And as he stands in victory, since curse has lost its grip on me, for I am his and he is mine, bought with the precious blood of Christ. No guilt in life, no fear in death, this is the power of Christ in me. from life's first cry to final breath. Jesus commands my destiny. No power of hell, no scheme of man can ever pluck me from his hand till he returns or calls me home. Here in the power of Christ I'll stand. Here in the power of Christ I'll stand.
Hallelujah, you may be seated. And kids, you can come up, and I need the orange mic, or something. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. And Drew, can I ask a favor? Can you head to drums? Thanks.
Very cool.
Test 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, super, super, super. Wow, we've got a lot of kids today. Should I sit out front? Should we do that? Yes? Okay, I'll sit out front. You guys can be leaders today. Oh. Hear that groan? Oh. I don't know if I can sit cross-legged even, right? How old am I again? I can't remember. How's it going? Good. Hey, can we do something? We probably do this before. Can I get names? Because I'm pretty sure I know all your names, but I don't know if you all know each other's names. Can we do that? Okay, who's going to be shy and not go first? Okay, Amelia, Addison, Charlotte, Dalton, hey, Ayla, nice to meet all of you, very cool. All right, so here's what we're going to do today. Drew, are you ready? Spoilers, I haven't told Drew what we're doing yet. Okay, so how many senses do you know what the word senses means? Yeah, not like the thing that they take every, what is it, 4 years, 10 years, census? Not a census, but your senses. How many senses do you have? 5. Do you know what they are? Smell, taste, sight, hearing, and touch. Very cool. We're going to deal with 2 of them today. Okay. So, Drew, what I want you to do is this. When I tell you to, I just want you to give us a real steady beat. Okay? All right. So here's what I want all of us to do. It's going to be pretty cool, I promise. All right? I want everyone in the sanctuary to close your eyes. And as Drew gives us the beat, I want all of us to clap to the beat, okay? Can you do that? Can you close your eyes? Everyone's eyes are closed. No cheating. All right, Drew. Whenever you're ready, go ahead and clap. Or go ahead and give us the beat. And I want everyone to keep clapping, but Drew, I want you to stop suddenly, okay? And stop. And everyone stop clapping. What did you hear? It stopped. It did, didn't it? What else did? You can open your eyes too. Sorry. Y'all can open your eyes now. What did you hear? You heard clapping, right? It's not a trick question, I promise. You heard clapping, though, but your eyes were closed, weren't they? How did you know how to clap in time with everyone? You just heard, didn't you? Uh-huh. Uh-huh. You just heard. How often do you use your eyes? A lot, a lot. What's your favorite color? Orange. Anyone else? Purple, pink, What, teal? That's an awesome color. What's your guys' favorite color? Blue, red, yellow? Any others? Teal? Mm-hmm. What's your guys' favorite smell? Ramen noodles. Chocolate. So this is one of my favorite smells. Why don't you come up? Come up. Come up with me. Come up with me. Come on up. It'll come eventually. Can you smell that? Ramen noodles. Chocolate. So this is one of my.
Oh, that's interesting.
Smells.
I've never had that happen
before. Come up. Come up with me. Come up with me. This is kind of trippy. I'm hearing myself, right? Can you smell that yet? Maybe not. You can. That is my favorite smell in the world. Do you know that? Blown out candles after church. It'll come eventually. Can you smell that?
Ramen noodles.
Go ahead and take the... So this is one of my...
That's interesting.
The greens.
I've never had that happen.
Come on. Come up with me. Come up with me. The auxiliary.
This
go ahead and turn
trippy.
It off.
I'm hearing myself, right?
Can you smell that yet? Maybe not. You can. That is my favorite smell.
So here, I'm going to try and... Can you all hear that? You can hear that too?
Wow.
It'll come eventually.
So...
Can you smell that?
Ramen noodles.
Go
ahead and take the...
this is perfect.
That's interesting.
I've never had that
happen. Come on. Come up with me. Come up with me. The auxiliary. Go ahead and turn it off.
I can hear that too.
Can you smell that yet? Maybe not. You can. That is my favorite smell.
So here, I'm going to try and... Can you all hear that? You can hear that too?
Wow.
It'll come eventually.
So...
Can you smell that?
Ramen noodles.
Go
ahead and take the...
this is perfect.
That's interesting.
The greens.
I've never had that happen. Come on. Come on. Come on. The auxiliary. Go ahead and turn it off.
Hear that too.
Can you smell that yet? Maybe not. You can. That is my favorite smell.
So here, I'm going to try and... Can you all hear that? You can hear that too?
Wow. It'll come eventually.
So,
ramen noodles.
Go ahead and take the...
this is perfect.
That's
one green. The auxiliary, go ahead and turn it off.
So can you trust your senses?
Can you smell that yet? Maybe not. You can. That is my favorite.
But I'm not
so
talking, am I?
So here, I'm going to try and... Can you all hear that?
See,
you can hear that too?
Come eventually.
You can't
so,
trust your senses, right?
Ramen noodles.
Go ahead and take
see.
The...
what you hear, you typically hear.
This is perfect.
That's one
green. The auxiliary, go ahead and turn it off.
So can you trust your senses?
Can you smell that yet? Maybe not. You can. That is my favorite.
But I'm not
so,
talking, am I?
Here, I'm going to try and... Can you all hear...
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let's sit down again.
So you know the story of Christ, right? He was born when we celebrate Christmas, and then he lived and he grew and he loved and he taught and he cared for many, many people, and then he died, right? And then he was buried in a tomb. Then what happened? He rose from the dead, didn't he? Yeah. He rose from the dead. Came back to life, and then he visited his disciples. Now, do you know anyone that's come back from the dead? Anyone out there know anyone that's come back from the dead? Personally? No, right? So do you think the disciples were trusting their senses? They could see Jesus, right? They could hear Jesus, right? But what was wrong? Or what was strange? It wasn't wrong, it was just strange. Not at first, or at least they didn't think so at first, right? See, they didn't know if Jesus was real or not, if he was a ghost or a vision or a crazy fever dream, right? But in the gospel we're going to read today, do you know what he did? So he's on the shore, and his disciples are out in the boat, and he calls out to them and say, "Hey, guys, catch some fish. I'm hungry." And so they catch some fish, they bring it back, and what does Jesus do? Bless you. What do you guys do with fish? Do you eat fish? What do you do with fish? Just you eat it, right? So, here's the crazy thing.
Have you ever seen Jesus? No. Right? But there's a part in the Bible that says, blessed are those who believe without seeing. See, even though sometimes we can't see Jesus with our eyes or smell him with our nose or hear him with our ears, we feel him deep inside that he's real, that love is still there, that the Spirit is still moving. So, even when the sound system does what it does, right? And there's echoes in your hearing, and you can't necessarily trust what you're hearing because you don't know if I'm talking or the sound system's talking. And even when your eyes are closed and you're all clapping along together, there is something deeper than just our five senses. Cool? Cool. You guys have been great. Hey, everyone, can you give them a round of applause? Thank you. All right, I'm going to see if I can get up without groaning and making old man noises, and then we can go back to our seats, okay? Wait. Let's pray. You can stay there, Spencer. God, thank you. Thank you for these kids. Thank you for this community. Thank you for the craziness that happens on Sunday mornings. Lord, bless these children. Teach them how to sense you without seeing, without feeling, without hearing, smelling, tasting. Lord, teach all of us how to feel your presence throughout every moment of every day. Through Christ our Lord, we pray. Amen. Thanks, kids. What a ride, friends. Breathe in, breathe out. Terry, how much time you got for offering? What?
A minute.
A minute? Okay. Friends, this is our time for offering, and we'd like to thank everyone who makes this worship service possible. Seriously, thank you. We invite you to take this moment to reflect on the ways that God's been good, the ways that God has kept the show going, the ways that he's provided for us. Friends, we invite you to reflect and to feel gratitude that it might blossom into generosity. Almighty God, we thank you for the ways that you have blessed us. Lord, may our offerings, may our tithes, may the things that we give up for the blessing of our community, Lord, may you bless them. God, we thank you that we have so much to give, that we have so much to be thankful for.
May that gratitude be ever within our hearts, and may we know that you are here with us, even when it doesn't seem like it. Lord, may we trust, may we believe, may we have faith that you are with us. Through Christ our Lord, we pray. Amen. So if you would like to stand with us and raise your voices in praising our God through the doxology, we would love it if you did that as well.
Praise God from whom all blessings flow. Praise him, all creatures here below. Praise him above the heavenly host. Praise Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Amen.
So with the confidence of the children of God, we invite you to pray with us the prayer that Christ has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Friends, you may be seated. Our gospel today comes from the Gospel of John, chapter 21, verses 1 through 14. Afterward, Jesus appeared again to his disciples by the Sea of Tiberias. It happened this way. Simon Peter, Thomas, called Didymus, Nathanael from Cana in Galilee, the sons of Zebedee, and two other disciples were together. "I'm going out to fish," Simon Peter told them, and they said, "We'll go with you." So they went out and got into the boat, but that night they caught nothing. Then early in the morning, Jesus stood on the shore, but the disciples did not realize that it was Jesus. He called out to them, "Friends, haven't you have any fish?" "No," they answered. So he said, "Throw your net on the right side of the boat and you'll find some." When they did, they were unable to haul the net in because of the large number of fish. Then the disciple whom Jesus loved said to Peter, "It is the Lord." And as soon as Simon Peter heard him say, "It is the Lord," he wrapped his outer garment around him, for he had taken it off, and jumped into the water. The other disciples followed in the boat, towing the net full of fish, for they were not far from shore, about 100 yards. When they landed, they saw a fire of burning coals there with fish on it and some bread. Jesus said to them, "Bring some of the fish you have just caught." Simon Peter climbed aboard and dragged the net ashore. It was full of large fish, but even with so many, the net was not torn. Jesus said to them, "Come, have breakfast." None of the disciples dared ask him, "Who are you?" They knew it was the Lord. Jesus came, took the bread, and gave it to them, and did the same with the fish. This was now the third time Jesus appeared to his disciples after he was raised from the dead. The good news of Jesus Christ. Amen. You know when things happen in the service and then the pastor changes their sermon up a little bit? I want us to recall back a year ago, maybe a little more than a year ago or a little less, but I want you all to recall back a year ago. Remember where you were sitting or where you were or what you were planning on doing the next month. For many of us, it was trying to figure out what a pandemic looked like. But for me, it was trying to figure out how do we put an entire service online, just to get through, because We'll certainly be done by Easter, won't we? And what was fascinating throughout this process is that I learned that sometimes what's going on in the sanctuary or in the chapel is where we were, is not necessarily what people are seeing on the screen. It was a very strange moment for me after one service one Sunday. I looked out and I saw the camera and the cords and the computer and the microphones and everything. And what didn't I see? People. But none of you saw that, did you? No, none of you saw that. What you saw was hopefully, I'm not going to say it was perfect, I'm not going to say it was even professional, but hopefully what you saw was the gospel being read, good news being preached, and voices being lifted up from our own people in song. See, I think today, and especially in our world today, this idea that reality is a little bit strange actually fits into the gospel. Jeff, can you put some words up on the screen? I don't care what words they are, any of them. It doesn't matter, it really doesn't. See, you see words on the screen, right? Very good. Those at home, you'll probably see the words on your screen. People in the sanctuary, do you see any words down here at all? Shake your heads, no. This is a softball question. The same way during the children's message. I'm not sure what happened, but up there, thank you. By the way, can everyone give a round of applause to the people in the booth right now? Thank you. I know, I'm embarrassing you. But standing up there and hearing my voice be replayed back to me, stuff that I said not moments ago, there's not much that can shake me up here, friends, but that kind of shook me. Because sometimes our eyes deceive us, sometimes we mishear what people say. My daughter's favorite phrase is, "What did you say? What did you say? Nora, we've repeated it 3 times already. Please use your ears this time." And strangely enough, she'll be sitting in the back of the van and I'll be talking quietly to someone on the phone, and then she'll hear every single word that I say. Incredible. But sometimes our senses deceive us. Sometimes it's hard to get a grasp on what actually happened. Did I really hear that person say that? Did I really just see this thing take place? And it only gets more confusing as we deal with a digital world, as we deal with online and news clips and video and augmented reality and all of this. But I think we today fit right at home with the disciples back then. So as I'm reading this passage, as I'm thinking through, and especially as I'm sitting up here, I'm thinking this is exactly what's happening. So the word that I'm about to give you doesn't necessarily matter what the word is. See, I'm a church nerd. I am. And in seminary, they teach you all of these wonderful heresies. Do you know what the word heresy means? You're just believing the wrong thing is what it is, right? Or you're proclaiming the wrong thing. And so one of these heresies was docetism. You don't need to remember that word. What you need to remember, though, docetism, right? Docetism. The whole point of this one was Jesus didn't have a real body. Now track with me for a little bit. I think this one's fascinating, and I think it matters today too. Jesus didn't have a real body. You could see how some people would believe this, can't you? That Jesus comes back from the dead. He can appear wherever after the resurrection. We're not quite sure. We can't remember all too well when he was alive on earth what happened. But for whatever reason, how does this all work? How does someone come back from the dead? So the idea was Jesus had a body that seemed like a body. He had flesh and bones that appeared to be flesh and bones. But it wasn't real, it was just spiritual. Now, quick disclaimer, that is a heresy. And remember what a heresy is? It's not the right thing. It's not what we actually believe. And so there were a couple hundred years where people argued this. I know this seems like such a strange thing to argue, doesn't it? Naturally, Jesus had a body. Otherwise, why does all of this theology fit? So on and so on and so on. But I think it's fascinating to me that some of these ideas still have weight today. Or at least those arguments and discussions and hard-won truths can teach us something today, too. I want to go back to this passage here. So Jesus was on the shore, and when the disciples landed, they saw a fire of burning coals with fish on it and some bread. And Jesus said to them, "Bring some of the fish you have just caught." And Simon Peter climbed aboard and dragged the net ashore, and it was full of large fish, 153, by the way. But even with so many, the net was not torn. And Jesus said to them, "What? Come and have breakfast." What'd you have for breakfast this morning? If you're like me, nothing. I don't trust myself up here to have breakfast, right? I really don't. But what did you have for breakfast this morning? Or what are you going to have for breakfast tomorrow? What is your favorite breakfast to have? Go ahead, shout it out. I know we've got to retrain ourselves, right? What? Say it again. French toast. What else?
Bagels.
That's what I'm talking about. What else? Pop-Tarts. Yes. It's awesome. What else?
Cinnamon rolls,
cereal. What, Dan?
Bacon and eggs.
Bacon and eggs. Man after my own heart. We have bodies, don't we? We eat food, and there's food that we actually enjoy, right? I'm reminded with the Pop-Tarts that my sister lived on Pop-Tarts for like 5 years. There's food that we enjoy because we have bodies, because they matter, because we have to feed them. Because these bones and this flesh needs nourishment. And so remember, back just a chapter ago, when Jesus appears to Thomas, remember what Thomas said, right? And this is why I love Thomas. Jesus said, Thomas says, "If I don't touch Jesus, if I don't feel him with my own hands, with one of my senses, you know, seeing, hearing, I got to touch this guy. I got to put my hand in his side and feel the holes in his wrists." Thomas never actually, at least the gospel never says that Thomas touches Christ. I'm sure he did, but interesting that it doesn't say that explicitly. So I can understand how the disciples are thinking, is this just a fever dream? Is this real? Does Christ actually have a body? So friends, I think that's why we find stories like this where Christ says, "Let's have breakfast." Where after he's risen from the dead, you find him actually interacting physically with his disciples. Now, this might seem like church trivia. This might seem like some of that high, up in the clouds theology that doesn't bear any actual weight today. And I wouldn't blame you for thinking like that, because at first, when I was learning these heresies, I'm thinking this is never going to come up in the church. I'll study them. I'll put them down on the test, but this is never going to come up in the church. But today, friends, I think we find something fascinating. I think we find something fascinating of a God who has risen from the dead and says, "Yes, your flesh, your bones, your blood, it matters. Your bodies matter." Because I think today what we are really, really good at is compartmentalizing. I think what we're really, really good at, especially in the church, in this area, is to say that there is spiritual stuff that we've got to get right, and then all the other stuff, we'll figure it out. But as far as us here in the church, it's really everything in the soul. But we don't see that here, do we? We don't see a God who just came back in spirit. We see a God who came back in flesh and blood. And it makes me wonder, why was that so important? What can that teach us today? Spring is halfway done, thereabouts. I know, are you ready for summer weather? I don't know if I am yet. You've got all your cleaning done, though, right? Do you clean like I do? You don't know how I clean. Do you clean like I do, where you start with one thing? Maybe you're out there and you're saying, all right, I've got to take the recycling out. And so you go to the recycling and you get it bagged up and you start to take it out. And then you walk into the garage to put it in the back of the car. And then you look at the car. And then you say, well, I'm a couple thousand miles over on an oil change. Maybe I should get the car lifted up. And so you set the bag down and you go lift the car up to change the oil. And then as you're under there, you're thinking, I don't know where my wrenches are. I need to clean the garage so that I can find my wrenches. And then you leave the car up, and then you go clean your garage to find the wrenches. But then, when you're cleaning the garage, what do you find? Stuff from who knows how it got there of your children's clothing and toys, and you think, well, I got to go take this back inside. And so you grab the clothing, and you take it back inside. Does anyone clean like that? See, it's incredible, I think, how our minds work. And how sometimes we jump from thing to thing to thing to thing. And so, of course, we make these silos and these compartments, and we try and order our existence and our thoughts and our lives. But I think what we find here today is something different. I'm not saying that's a bad thing, by the way. But what's fascinating to me is this idea that Christ has come back from the dead and isn't just saying, it's only your religious life that matters. It's only your soul, your eternal soul that matters. Christ comes back, and what does he want to do with his disciples? He wants brunch. He wants to share a meal. He wants to know that his disciples are fed and cared for. Because of course he does, because this was his entire ministry, to heal the sick, to bring hope to the hopeless, to make sure that people know that they're loved. So how does this manifest itself today? What do we take from this? Friends, I don't know how you view the church. Everyone views it a little bit differently. That's one of the things that I've learned over these many years. The church is different to different people, or means something different to different people. But friends, for me, not just the building, but the community, right? The body of Christ, those of us who gather and proclaim that he is risen indeed. Friends, there is healing here. There is wholeness here. There's grace and compassion. At least I find myself surprised every time by how good God is in these moments. But I think one thing that I want to draw from this today, and I hope you draw this too, that grace, that healing, that compassion that you find on a Sunday morning, that refueling, that pit stop, that does not just have to be on a Sunday. See, if God cares about not just the spirit, but the whole body, and if God cares not just about the whole body, but maybe even the world that those bodies live in, I would imagine that God cares about not just a Sunday, but also a Monday and a Tuesday and the whole rest of the week. Don't misunderstand me, though. I'm not putting any more on your plate. But what I am saying is this: that grace, that healing, that hope, that lightness, that is possible every day, every moment. It doesn't just get confined to these walls. It doesn't just get confined to the issues that the church cares about. That the goodness and compassion of God is all over. So friends, I want to leave you with this last piece of scripture. Jeff, can you bring up Matthew? This is Matthew 11, 28 through 30. You've heard this one before, I think. Jesus says, "Come to me, all you who are weary and burdened, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls." I think Jesus, "For my yoke is easy and my burden is light." Thank you. See, I think Jesus is saying this very specifically. And when he comes back, he's opening the gates even more. He's tearing the curtain so that the presence of God might go throughout all the earth, all of existence, all of our lives. See, that grace is not just confined to 1 hour of the week anymore. That lightness, that ease, is possible. So throughout your day today, your week, your month, may you know, even without seeing or without hearing, that Christ has risen, that there is hope, that resurrection is possible, that love and grace, that compassion and gentleness, they are already here if we're willing to accept them. Christ is risen. Christ is risen indeed. Amen. Friends, we invite you to stand. We invite you to stand and sing with us our final hymn, "I'll Fly Away." And I'm going to turn it over to the praise team now.
Okay, this one we know, and we're going to need everybody's help, because we have no accompanist. We have Miss Linda's gone for some time, and then we know Terry takes off. So, we know this song, "I'll Fly Away," and we've got Drew on the drums that's going to keep us rocking and rolling. Let me get my words here, make sure we're...
And I know you can all keep time. We did that during the children's sermon. So.
Yeah. Okay, Drew. Are you ready? Here we go.
Some glad morning when the flock is o'er, I'll fly away. To a home on God's celestial shore, I'll fly away. I'll fly away, oh glory, I'll fly away. When I die, hallelujah, by and by, I'll fly away. When the shadows of this life are gone, I'll fly away. Land where joy shall never end, I'll fly away.
Good job.
Hallelujah. Friends, go ahead and take a seat. Go ahead, take a seat, take a seat, take a seat, take a seat. Just a few, just a short moment for prayers, joys, concerns, anything we want to lift up. Anything in house, real quick?
I'd just like to say we have a birthday today. Mary Thompson.
Woohoo!
And it's Dennis Bayless's too. And Sarah has, your wife, has a birthday
this
week.
Does she have
week.
One coming up, is that?
She does.
It's April 21st, I know it, don't worry.
And this next Saturday, Elaine Borman and Deanna Lambertson. So those are the birthdays.
Very good, thank you. Any other prayers, any prayers online that we can lift up?
One that's not on the list, not online, but Russ Daly, Dixie's son. He had a slight stroke last week, but he is home and recovering, so keep him in your prayers.
Yeah. Okay, thank you.
Yeah.
Our list up here, continued prayers for Fred Bryson, Rex and Lou Hickman, Sue and David Kinney, Karen Gowerly, Sally Mueller, Brad Coxhausen, Mary Thompson, Mac Neal, Della Staples, Bob Foster, Chris Anderson, and prayers for Liz Skillern and family who are dealing with the loss of her brother, Bruce Denny DeWild. So, any other prayers that we can lift up this morning? Friends, would you pray with me? Good and gracious God, thank you that you're a God who listens. Thank you that you're a God who sticks with us. Lord, we ask that you bless these people that we've named today. Those who need healing, give them healing. Those who need comfort, give them comfort. Those who are grieving and mourn, may they find comfort as well and peace. Almighty God, we thank you for every good thing that you've given us. We thank you for a congregation who gathers, who raises their voices, who blesses one another. We thank you for all of those who help run the service to make it possible, to keep it going. God, we thank you that you have given us the opportunity to praise you and your name. Lord, bless each of us. Bless those things we've lifted today out loud. Bless those things silent within our hearts. And Lord, may we know that you are with us, that your grace and your love is present. And may we accept it. Through Christ our Lord, we pray. Amen. Any announcements today?
I have several here. A reminder, scholarships, church scholarship applications are due this week in the office. Next week is Helping Hands. I'm sure need some help at 3 o'clock to get ready, and 4 o'clock passing out the food. Missions room, I don't know, Jody, if that'll be open next week as well.
Absolutely.
Okay. E-cycling is this Friday at Pella from 3 to 6. And today at 2 o'clock, if you haven't seen the high school musical, you need to go at 2 o'clock because we have two from the church there. Abby Ehlers is in there, and our own drummer, Drew Morlock, who's in the pit. So go and support them today if you haven't.
Thanks, Jeff. Any other announcements this morning? Friends? Would you please stand as you're able and receive the blessing. May God bless you. May God keep you. May God lift you up and give you peace. Friends, go now knowing that Christ cares for you, for our community, for our world, that Christ cares for everything. May you feel that love and that compassion. May it plant a seed deep within your hearts, and may you share it with all you meet. Go with God, and God will go with you. Amen. Amen. Grace, peace, blessings. Take care.
Touch your boss some way, God. In Jesus' name. Amen.
For so long I've carried the weight of my past. Crippled by burdens like stones on my back. I thought I'd fallen too far.
your grace. You came and showed me the way.